becoming, after every course run, we have one of these sessions, and good to see you people. So today, I'm just going to give you some, I believe most of you have heard me earlier also, so I'm not going to get back to the old stories of NPTEL and all that. Some basic updates on where we are at this stage. And also, I would like to spend some time today listening to all of you. That's more important, I believe, and that's the purpose of these SPOC workshops, to really understand what the needs are. So, yeah, first we'll do some reportings on where we are at the moment. And then, of course, Angana will talk about the some information on the SPOCs and developments there also. And also, there are a couple of slides about the future course of action. There are some points that we would like to make, and I would like to take your feedback on this. It's not that these are really something which have been implemented already, but before implementing it, I would like to get some feedback from you. So this is something which I have talked about earlier also, but after the last SPOC workshop, where the total video hours were 36,000, now we have reached to 40,000. So which is fairly, every semester, if we keep running like this, I'm sure no other online people who offer online courses would be able to match us. Not even, MIT or Coursera or any other application that way. So we have 40,000 video hours, subtitles. Last time it was 26,000. Last 6 months, about 3,000 more video hours have been added. There were about close to 423, if I remember correctly, million NPTEL website views, which has gone up to 430, 1.3 million YouTube subscriptions, text transcripts for about 35,000. This is going slightly slow. Last time it was about 34,000 or so, but still about 1,000 hours have been added to this. 1,500 plus courses. Last time it was 1,300, if you remember. And of course, 300 million YouTube views. We have not really, this remains the same because we have not really taken the Google Analytics for the YouTube hits, but I'm sure this has also gone up. So, from March 2014 till date, we have completed about 740 courses only on MOOCs. There have been 36 lakhs plus enrollment across the courses and 2.7 lakhs number of registrations in the exams. And I believe these numbers that are growing every day would never be possible without really active participation from all of you. And I would really take this opportunity to thank all of you for being so active in this national endeavor. Thank you very much.
I would like a big clap for all.
Yes, I think so. Ye vision mission bahut ho gaya, aage chalte hain. Isme I have already talked about it many times. So, I would like to spend some time on these two slides. These are, I may have shown this particular image earlier also. But if you really look at it, at least for those who are coming for the first time, components of a MOOC have all these five parameters. You have course content, which is in the form of video lectures. You have assignments, objectives, objective-subjective programming based. You have text transcript plus lab demos. You have live interactivity, interactive sessions by the faculty, and also discussion forums. Now, what is very important, and that is what I'm observing, and particularly it happens when we, like in the last semester, We offered a whitelisted course for the students of final year students of Abdul Kalam Technical University. Now, what happens when you're doing a whitelisted course, you know that these are the students and you can keep a much better track of their activities, what they're doing. Now, based on that, we can also do some analysis of how others might be using it, right? The feedback that we got from many colleges is that we have to devise, and that is something I believe you have to devise strategies within your institutions. Once the course content is uploaded, how do we ensure that students are actually seeing the lectures? You won't believe the kind of experiences which were quite shocking for me this time that we had after offering this course. Before the examinations, a particular college came up and said our students are not registered for this course. And we knew that we are offering the course for them. There were students who did not know that assignments have to be submitted. You know, these are things which SPOCs through the mentors have to, you know, look at. How at least you communicate to the students. I'm sure you can at least send a mail to the students community or at least have a poster or something. Find out whatever suits in your institution, some strategies to at least reach out to the students continuously. And this is all what we require actually. This is basically a slide that talks about learners' engagement with the course content. All that we are expecting is for the students to watch video lectures of 3 to 4 hours every week. Even otherwise, if they are registered for a course, they are expected to attend classes. Now here we are not compelling them to come to the class 8 o'clock sharp in the morning with the bell. All we are saying is, now you can also check your lectures on your mobile phones. So all you do is just find out some time in a week to listen to these lectures. It will only help you, I mean, help your students. Assignments, largely, if you take it up as something which is like a load or a pressure or something, that may not work. The main objective of giving assignments, and I and you, all of us teach, is only for the students to realize and test themselves where they stand. And that is something which you need to communicate to the students. Wo exam ke liye padhna or, you know, looking at the guidebooks and preparing for the exams, your seniors in notes leke, preparing for the exams, these are very short-term goals, and that's something which needs to be communicated to the students that this is not going to do any good to them. Of course, notes, text transcripts, references, they are being made available as much as possible. Generally, what we are observing, at least in this case also, that out of these 45,000 students who really registered for the courses, I would say only 2 to 3% of that were seriously asking questions. Now, again, I can understand there could be many reasons for it. I mean, maybe one of the major reasons that I have observed while teaching is many students feel that if they ask a stupid question, then people may laugh at them. And that's precisely the reason why they don't ask questions. Now, I don't know, I have started this practice and it's working out well, not for online courses, but you could also perhaps try this out when you teach courses. There are certain points given to the students every week, which is based on whether they have asked some questions or not, posted some questions or not. And that's something which becomes very important, because if you really ask a question, whether it's a good question or a bad question, doesn't matter. If it's a bad question, which essentially means that It's a simple question. You should know the answer. Or it is also possible that what you are asking is does not have an answer. But that doesn't matter. Finally, it is very important to hold a question, ask a question. Until and unless one does that, and that is something which needs to be encouraged. It's not just about listening to video lectures and appearing for the exams and completing assignments on time. Until and unless we really, really inculcate this habit in them of asking questions, I don't think we are doing the right job as teachers. They need to be inquisitive, and that's perhaps one of the things which becomes very important for all of us as teachers to understand. So as compared to July 2017, the number shows we have gone down, but this does not really include the whitelisted courses. So like in AKTU, there were 45,000 students registered in one course. There were similarly many other courses which were offered, which were whitelisted. So we have not really included these courses because we cannot report this to the ministry directly as part of the statistics that we have. Therefore, this looks less this time, but it is actually higher than the last number. Yeah, so about 9,34,156 students enrolled for the courses. Out of them, about 86,942 students registered for the exams, and about 76,125 students appeared for the exams. That's basically the highest so far. And I'm sure this time is going to go up again.
Shall we have some discussion on
this? Sure.
The point is, you know, the students which are enrolling and those who are appearing for the examination, the percentage is only, you know, less than 10%.
Right.
So that is the main concern. And in fact, we have seen in, you know, in our colleges also, though people are, you know, willing to learn, they are, you know, registering and also, you know, taking up the course, but not going for the examination, maybe some for the examination fees or something else. So can we increase this number from exam, you know, those who are registering and equal number to appearing in the examination? And that what you are asking, you know, why? Because when they are coming for the, this course, and taking up seriously, and then there is a testing body, and then they come with the result, right?
Right.
So, in fact, we are looking the outcome of that time.
Sure.
Sir, in our case too, in most of the cases, examination fee is being constrained for teachers, that very students.
Okay.
As I observe, what they speak.
Okay.
Sir, I have done one course from the Coursera. In that course, there was no time limit for the submission of the assignment. My concern is this, I have enrolled twice and thrice in the courses in the IIT, but the only point was that I have to submit assignment on time, which as a working professional, I'm not getting time to complete that particular videos in that time period and to submit assignment. If it is possible that I can submit all the assignment at the end of the course, then I think I would be able to do my course, which I have seen the difference between the Coursera and the individual courses. For me, that was a major concern because I was not able to complete my course, though I was very much ready.
Okay, let me take up one by one. Anyone else? Right. So your point first. Globally, if you look at it, whether it is edX or Coursera or whatever, total number of student, people who actually enroll for the courses, finally who complete the course, not all courses have examinations, assignments kar lo ya kuch bhi kar lo, that's about 4 to 5%. The dropout rates in online courses is very high. If I really look at it that way, we are still close to about 7-8%, much better than what others are doing, number one. what I'm observing here, that if it is made mandatory for the students to complete the course, appear for the examination, colleges which are actually doing it, then the results are definitely there. Without, I mean, you transfer credit or you do something, whatever it is, it is actually working out well in such institutions. And I can tell you, not many countries today have even thought of that, using online courses. We are in a much better state as compared to, as far as MOOCs is concerned. But of course, if we can really devise strategies together so that more and more students appear for the exams, it's very good. I was actually in, I don't know if I had told this to you, in one of the meetings, I was actually asked this question by one of the person sitting on the other side of the table. आप तो कहते हैं कि बहुत लोग बेनिफिट हो रहे हैं, ये तो ड्रॉप आउट रेट इतना है, 5% भी नहीं आते एग्जाम में. सो आई डोंट नो, द ओनली आंसर आई कुड गिव इज दैट इफ आई कुड पुट ऑल स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ऑल, यू नो, ही वाज वन ऑफ द आईआईटी डायरेक्टर्स एक्चुअली, वन ऑफ ऑल द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ ऑल द ओल्ड आईआईटीज टुगेदर, द टोटल नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स अपीयरिंग फॉर द एग्जाम्स आर मोर देन दैट. सो व्हाट आर यू टॉकिंग अबाउट, प्लीज, 76,000 इज नॉट अ स्मॉल नंबर. What is the strength of your IIT? Thankfully, he was not from my IIT. So immediately the secretary asked him, kya hai bhaiya, aapka strength kya hai? And then he was quiet. So the whole point I'm trying to make is that it will take time. Definitely it will take time, but there will be some way out. Okay? Your point. Very difficult question to answer. Trying our best that government pays for the examination fee, still nothing really has happened on that. And as far as offering the course is concerned, creating the content is concerned, managing the course content, course run is concerned, we get funding from the government for this. As far as examination is concerned, government is not really willing to pay for that. We are trying to bring the cost as low as possible. Right now it is, in fact, there is a slide where I'll tell you, with students with reserve category and others, we have kind of tried to bring it down as much as possible. But 1,000 right now, if you really look at the value prospects, then I think 1,000 is not really a very high amount. I understand it can be high for some people. I don't believe that it is so high for teachers, number one.
Sir, especially I am talking about the teachers. Teachers clearly mention.
Sir, teachers to mention karenge. Ab bekar ka 1,000 rupees dene mein kisko acha lagta hai? But the whole point is that 1,000 rupees agar ek teacher nahi de sakta hai, to wo theek nahi hai. Itna hi main keh sakta hu. I know. To tabhi main bhi unhi ki tarah bol raha hu na. To mujhe sirf itna hi kehna hai ki 1,000 rupees agar aapko koi bolta hai, आप उनसे इतना ही बोल सकते हैं कि आप मोबाइल बिल का थोड़ा सा वो इस्तेमाल कम करें मोबाइल का और कुछ पैसे बचा लें.
सर, मेरा ये एक्सपीरियंस है कि अगर आप पेमेंट करते हैं तो फिर आप सीरियस हो जाते हैं. अगर आप पेमेंट
एब्सोल्युटली मैम, एब्सोल्युटली आई एग्री विथ यू कम्प्लीटली. अभी आई एम जस्ट नाउ एक्सपीरियंसिंग दिस. आई हैव अनदर प्रोजेक्ट कॉल्ड DIC डिजाइन इनोवेशन सेंटर. उसमें वी आर काइंड ऑफ ऑफरिंग दीज इंटर्नशिप्स टू स्टूडेंट्स. तो इंटर्नशिप में जब बुलाते हैं उनको, ऑब्वियसली आई फील बैड चार्जिंग द स्टूडेंट्स, सो आई टेक केयर ऑफ देयर अकोमोडेशन, फूड एंड ऑल दैट. बट आई एम ऑब्जर्विंग दिस ट्रेंड, व्हेन आई पे समथिंग देयर, यू नो, इट्स द सेम थिंग दैट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. दे फील, आइदर दे फील दैट हाँ आई डिजर्व इट, देयरफॉर आई एम हियर, बट दैट इज नॉट ट्रू. इट्स नॉट दैट दे रियली डिजर्व इट. देयर कुड बी अ बेटर कैंडिडेट हु कुड हैव used the opportunity in a much better way. The whole point that I'm trying to make is that let's not encourage this. As far as students are concerned, I can still understand. There are students, I mean, you won't believe the kind of places that we have been to in last 4-5 months, the students that we have met. There are students who genuinely require support, and we are continuously talking. I'll talk about some of the companies which are actually supporting us now. I mean, genuinely try to support the students, but फॉर फैकल्टी यार मना करो उनको, बोलो कि भाई अगर करना है तो इट्स गोइंग टू बी यूजफुल फॉर यू, सो डू इट. But yes, one good thing that has happened, and now I think your faculty members will also be happy that I'm going to talk about some new developments as far as faculty development program, FDP, FLP, jo bhi bolte hain aap log. So your colleges will be getting some letters very soon from AICT and the ministry as well. There are certain things which are being approved actually. So I'm going to talk about that shortly. Usme ho sakta hai ki na lage paise. Dekhta hu main, let me just check it out what it is. And Coursera, yes. So, true, but tell me something. If you allow your students in the same way, will that work? It will not work. What I was talking about is faculty development programs. There are going to be credits given to the faculty, and instead of traveling, taking leave, leaving your home, managing everything, leaving back everything, going to some institution to do one of these refresher courses, you will now be able to take up these courses, and that will add to your credits there. Now, in that, we can perhaps explore some of these possibilities. But in general, what our observation has been that if we we definitely can extend time of submission of the assignments, but if you have these weekly assignments, that is constantly in your mind, and that actually helps, because otherwise neither the teacher is there nor you are supposed compelled to go to a classroom to do. Wo generally dimag se nikal jata hai, wo finally wo lagta hai ki 12th week mein we will complete the assignments, but then you never know 12th week mein kya hoga, so it doesn't work. Right, so dekhte hain usko. We can always explore possibilities. Yeah, this is an interesting slide. What we have, if we really look at this particular part, the initial enrollment into the course versus submission of the first assignment. See how it goes down. आपने जो कहा ना अभी कि वो exams पूरे नहीं देते हैं, think of it, classes शुरू नहीं हुई हैं, एक week चला है बस, assignment 21% is giving, submitting. Dropout rates in some courses where the students find quick benefits. A programming का कोई course ले लो आप, C++ ले लो या कुछ ले लो जिसमें they know that immediately it has a value to them. Versus a course on maybe introduction to philosophy, dropout rates will be very high. Now, when you look at that particular data, if I show you the data which is per course, you will see what are the kind of courses where students appearing for the exams is very close to actual students who really enrolled in the course. It largely depends on courses. Enrollment versus registration, yes, about 9% of the students registered, but as I said, this is still higher as compared to the practices we are seeing in other online platforms. Yes, this number is going up, and what is the total number of course being offered? Yeah.
269.
Starting from
July.
But does that also include the whitelisted courses if they are being offered, or courses to the industry that we are offering? No. Okay. So, fine. So there are a lot of these courses that we are also offering for the industry now, depending on their needs, and perhaps we'll try to keep those courses open for when we actually start the faculty development program courses. So yeah, 269 is the number as of now, and this data is about a week back, so I'm sure the numbers have gone up now, 6 lakhs plus. Yes, if you remember 2 years back, When I was showing this slide, it was only IIT Madras and IIT Kanpur. Now, of course, IIT Kharagpur has suddenly got into this whole thing, and which has really strengthened us quite a bit. So they have, in the last course run and the course run before that, they have added a lot more courses. So about 1,010 courses, these are largely the MOOCs courses that I'm talking about. Type of courses being offered from March 2014 till 2018, about 483 new courses, 49 repurposed courses, and about 208 reruns. Now, if you repurpose courses, I believe you know, these courses which we had developed earlier from 2002 to 2014, some of these courses, I mean, these were mostly courses of 40 hours duration, 1 hour of lecture and all that. So they have to be repurposed for the requirements, to meet the requirements of MOOCs. So they are being sliced into half an hour lectures. And there are very interesting experiences that we are having. So there was this professor who had actually done a course earlier, back in 2008 or 9. So he was very keen on, in fact, there was a requirement that came from the colleges that that course need to be offered as MOOC. So gentleman comes to the editing studio and very nicely he sliced these lectures. And then he realized that, look, I mean, from moving to one topic to the other topic, after I slice this 1 hour lecture, I need to give an introduction. So I said, yeah, I knew what he's going to face now at home. So then he went back home and then called me, but I don't have those shirts with me. What do I do? So, you know, those kind of things keep happening here. Kuch loge to baal bhi safed ho gaye hain. So between two lectures, suddenly he appears with a white hair and then gets back in a normal mode. But anyway, these are nice things that keeps happening. So as far as July, the course run that is going to start, we have about 114 reruns and 155 new courses. Duration of courses, of course, the 4 weeks courses are less, 139 courses, about 104 8 weeks courses, and 126 12 weeks courses. So generally what we are observing that these 8 weeks courses have the highest demand. But in the last 2-3 course runs, we are also realizing that these 12 weeks courses, now that many institutions are using these courses for credit transfer or making it mandatory for their students to take up the courses, the demand for the 30 hours courses is going up. Yeah, so exam attendance percentage again does not include the whitelisted courses. For example, the examination for this particular course in AKTU was conducted by AKTU. We only gave them the question paper and the model answers. Pass percentage has been, again, for the number of courses that we offered, 87% is a decent number. And this is something which I'm happy about, because this was one of the fears that not just we had, but also a fear that was expressed by the colleges earlier. You IIT wala professor hai, kya padhayega, pata nahi, mere bachcho ko samajh mein aayega, nahi karega, fail ho jayega, kuch hoga. So that was one of the concerns, but now I see that, and I'm sure it's not just because IIT professor jo padhata tha, wahi padha raha hai wo. It's only that the mentors are doing a good job, and students also understand the needs of it today. And I believe that could be only reason that I see. This was again during this particular last course run examination, we conducted a survey found this particular data, which is very clear that about 35%, which is the highest, your college or faculty encouraged you to enroll. And again, I'm really very thankful to all the colleges for doing this good job. I still remember back in 2004, I was in Raipur in one of the colleges. that time we were setting up this e-classrooms for the universities in Raipur, where we could beam lectures from IIT Kanpur directly to them. There was a tremendous fear among the faculty there that perhaps our jobs are going to go away now, which I kept on telling that e-classroom cannot replace real classroom situation. It's just something which is like a supplementary thing. We are offering courses now. In the current course, about 16,000 faculty, I believe. They appeared for the examinations. They completed the examinations. Now we believe that they are much better equipped today to teach the courses. Why are we needed here? So, I mean, this initiative is good, but it is not going to be a permanent initiative. It will run for maybe next 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, 10 years. Usse jyada kahan karenge log? And eventually, I'm sure the requirements will also go down. I know there are teachers who have done about 7 or 8 courses on NPTEL, and they've got good grades in that. I'm sure they have also done this as students. But maybe as students, they were not so serious. I mean, frankly, if you ask me the courses that I teach, I never took those courses very seriously when I was a student. But then the whole point is that if I am refreshing them by doing these courses, I am much better equipped today to go back and teach my students. That's the whole purpose. It was never intended to replace this noble profession of teachers. It was just there to help them out, so that they can pass on.
But the fear is still existing, sir.
I know, sir. I keep getting these mails.
At that time, many people included these courses, that NCR courses, na? So my college people were saying, yaar, dekho, ye jobs khale hamari. So they think, sir, please let.
I agree. Completely agree.
Ye hota kya hai ki they think ki hum aap laptop chala denge ya screen pe chala denge, and that is sufficient. So aap isse please clear kariye, sir, because most of the people think that this is okay.
But I believe to a large extent that has been clarified now, because now AKTU of course has taken some policy that there are some courses which are mandatory for the students to take up. But
this semester I don't think so there is any mandatory course. Earlier there was, sir.
No, there is no specific course which is mandatory, but if they do some NPTEL courses, they will get some credits for it.
Yes,
right? So, which in a way takes care of that problem to a large extent. Yeah. So, which in a way is good. Matlab, zaruri nahi hai ki har...
Some courses for, I think so, for Indina, etc. But then those courses were not included, therefore they have exported the courses. Indina course chalaye the, sir, lekin wo aapke mein is baar chal nahi rahe the, to unko hatana pada. Earlier the syllabus were there when they put up. They said these courses should be mandatory.
Okay.
So now those courses are mandatory.
I will still, I'll confirm with the dean there and get back to you on this. Lalti, just keep a note of this. Huh? We'll have to just talk to Professor Vineet Kansal and get back to this. But yes, I mean that, I understand that fear will be there for some time. But agar wo bolte hain, toh itna hi keh sakte hain, aap bhi register kar lo, course mein exam de lo. Aur bas ek do saal padhayenge. Ab, for example, this particular course, we are offering it again. But it's not compulsory. Your college has to offer that course. And the reason why I insisted that we are not going to offer the same course second time, because I thought that those two teachers who were otherwise mentoring the students or otherwise they were responsible for teaching this course should have done the course this time and they can teach it next time in a much better way. So that was the whole purpose. Now, there are ways, there are... वो जहाँ भी जाते हैं हम बोलते हैं यार मतलब मैं बोलता हूँ एंड्रयू बोलते हैं सब बोलते हैं हम लोग ठीक है लिख भी देंगे कोई बात नहीं यप सो दिस नंबर इज ऑल्सो गोइंग अप एवरीथिंग इज वेरी गुड एक्चुअली सो अबाउट 53,000 male students and 34,000 female students, which is good, again. Yeah. 16,000 plus faculty registered in January, April 2018 courses, which is कहीं ना कहीं तो लग रहा होगा ना उनको भी ठीक है कर ही लेते हैं यार कोर्स
मतलब
नहीं नहीं आप तो करते ही हैं आई नो यू ऑल आर वेरी सिंसियर पीपल बट पीपल दैट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट Okay, that is good. Yeah, so this is distribution of highest marks across. So you can see clearly 385 courses between 91 and 100. And number of toppers, of course, 481 courses. So this is also pretty clear that there are very few courses which are very easy. So, which essentially means that the standards are being maintained here. We kept on getting this request from students, from colleges that wo bahut difficult hai, content jo hai wo hamare syllabus ka nahi hai, all kinds of things are happening. But still we said that we are not going to compromise on the standards, which is pretty evident with this slide. Yeah, there are some acknowledgements. Last time I was actually presenting it, so there were people from, I mean, some of them were there, so I had to do the acknowledgements. So yes, but I'm really thankful to Mr. Subramaniam, Secretary MHRD, who has been really supporting this particular initiative, and he's very keen that more teachers benefit from the courses. Google, of course, has been with us since 2006, and they have, particularly Ashwini Sharma, has been really helpful in the platform that you're using. The course builder platform that we're using is continuously in a state of change. There, with every course run, there are new features which are added. There are bugs which are removed. So Ashwini Sharma, Abhinav Khandelwal, Devi Tej, all these people, and they are all doing it not for money. They don't charge us a penny for the kind of time and effort that they actually put in this. From Asin Technologies, Dr. Nuzhat and Mudassir, both of them have been again very helpful. They have really with their sponsorship, particularly in CSR funds that they've given. Again, I mean, I believe they are extremely helpful, but these are the culprits. Agar ye free kar dete hain, toh hum bhi free kar denge. So, problem is there because what happens is TC SAN platform, and you have to understand that to conduct an examination, it's not just the examination centers. It's the deployment of human resources and so many other things that gets involved in the process that we really have to, in fact, 1,000 rupees that we are charging, trust me, we are trying to take out some money from the sponsorships that we have to make sure that the money does not go beyond that. Of course, the text transcription ke liye, we have tied up with these companies. They are helping us with this. It is really, the work has been speeded up now. About 4 years ago, we had people sitting with, you know, headphones listening to the lectures and typing them in our offices. But now, of course, the text transcript is being done by this. Yeah. Now I think I would leave it to Angana. Yes, I'll come back to you again. Yes, tell me.
Sir, myself, Ravdeep Singh from GNH. I just have one question. Sir, why the answers for the final exam questions are not being shared with the students? Because that is really important for them as well as teachers.
It is true. I have a PIC meeting some 3rd of August. I was actually, because this is something which I was told from some of my colleagues at IIT Kanpur also. They were interested in sharing the answer scripts. But the only problem is that we ourselves need to be clear about one thing. In spite of all efforts that we're putting, we came across some incidences where some questions were repeated from the previous exams. And if you remember, earlier we used to share the answers. As soon as that happened, we said, that's not fair. So, of course, we have taken action against people who have actually done that. But that is one reason, but I'm sure this will be sorted out very soon. Yeah. नहीं तो उसका तो वी हैव इनफैक्ट अंगना इज गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट इट वी हैव नहीं तो आपके वहां से कितने कहां पर है आपका
जैसे उदयपुर राजस्थान
उदयपुर में
जैसे एक सेंटर जयपुर है तो वो काफी दूर है सर 9 घंटे की जर्नी है हां वो पॉसिबल नहीं होता गर्ल्स के लिए
और उदयपुर आपके यहां से कितने स्टूडेंट्स रजिस्टर कर रहे हैं
सर जैसे पिछली बार 1400 स्टूडेंट एनरोल हुए थे पर एग्जाम के लिए रजिस्टर 50 नहीं कर पाए वो सेंटर नहीं था
नहीं समझ रहा हूँ मैं नहीं एक्चुअली हो क्या रहा है कि जब हम लोगों को कुछ एश्योरेंस मिल रहा है कि ऐसे इस जगह से एग्जामिनेशन में रजिस्ट्रेशन होंगे तब हम बोल रहे हैं वो थोड़ा सा एक हाइपोथेटिकल सिचुएशन हो रहा है अदरवाइज कैन यू डू वन थिंग जस्ट चेक आउट ऑल द कॉलेजेस व्हिच आर लोकल चैप्टर्स और इवन अदरवाइज चेक द डेटा एंड ड्रॉ सम टेबल ऑन हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स कैन वी रियली एक्सपेक्ट टू रजिस्टर इफ वी मेक अनदर सेंटर इन उदयपुर हाउ मच would we expect, ठीक है उस basis पे we can propose this time, I prepare it before 3rd of this month.
Sir, every SPOC is asked whether 200 plus students are visiting from your center or not, but say I am working at Greater NOIDA, there are many colleges, from every college there may be say 100 students, but there may not be
नहीं दैट्स व्हाट आई वाज टेलिंग है ना सो वी हैव टू चेक आउट द कॉलेजेस इन दिस पर्टिकुलर रीजन आई मीन चेक आउट ऑल द कॉलेजेस इन उदयपुर एंड नियर बाय एरियाज एंड टेल मी जोन वाइज कितने होंगे उसमें
राजस्थान में सर अभी एनपीटेल का देखो बहुत कम है स्पेस राजस्थान में पूरे इंडिया में राजस्थान में सबसे कम पे उसका कारण भी एक सेंटर की उदयपुर एजुकेशन साइंस के लिए सबसे बड़ा उदयपुर है जयपुर से भी ज्यादा उदयपुर को लोग साइंस एजुकेशन के लिए मानते हैं
नहीं नहीं ठीक है इनफैक्ट राजस्थान में आई थिंक वी हैव कंडक्टेड ओनली वन वर्कशॉप राइट चलिए आते हैं उदयपुर यस एक सेकेंड यस नो नो इट्स सिली क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस No, there is no restriction.
No, restriction is not there.
Huh?
Enrollment as a student, enrollment as a
अदर्स करके कुछ नहीं बताएंगे
बट
No, but tell me something. I mean, if somebody, I need to check that. If somebody who's neither a teacher nor a student, there are people who are registering, right?
No.
What no? I mean, there are students who are, there are people
but
who are registered.
They enroll, but they cannot.
No, they enroll under the name of student only. Yes. They don't have an alternative.
Ajit Chari, we'll get one something added to that. No, we'll just say others. Because otherwise it'll be a huge list. चलिए ऐड करवा देंगे बिल्कुल I'll get it done, don't worry. Yes.
First of all, very good morning. Thank you so much for this very nice session. I'm Vijay Shwati from MIT University Greater Noida campus. We have recently established local chapter.
Sorry, where are you from?
MIT University Greater
Noida. MIT, yeah. Okay.
So we have recently opened this UK local chapter campus. And in our university curriculum, there is a section of MOOCs as per UGC.
I know.
We are planning to float the subject into the student domain.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to know that how we can have great transfer from your side or from us. Great transfer.
No, see. We can give you credit transfer if you take up courses offered by us.
Yes, definitely.
No, I mean, who is offering the course?
Sir, we have in our university curriculum, there is a MOOCs section that a student can opt a subject that is Joel Community Compile.
Right.
We can float this subject into the student domain that you have to opt a course on the NPTEL.
But we should have a course like that, right?
Yes, yes,
we have a course?
It is available.
And is it being offered in the current semester?
Yes,
it is currently offered.
Okay. Let Angana finish this. I have a list of colleges who have adopted various different ways of kind of collaborating with NPTEL, and I'm sure you'll find your answer there.
This concept I was also wanting to explain. I mean, Professor Ashish Shapna, Professor and Dean,
Secretary
of Physical Sciences, so I have just registered. I have gone through three courses of NPTEL, and I remain the gold medalist also. 99% marks in physics, IIT Madras. So actually we are going to UGC based, credit based system. And if we incorporate these courses in our curriculum, then it becomes mandatory for the student to pass that course. If we give this credit to the student in his certificate of the university, this is a separate certificate, separate in the university certificate. Then definitely the student will come to enroll in this course.
No, but that is happening now, no? Because, I mean, AKTU, for example, they have adopted this particular policy in the academic council meeting itself that happened. So, what, some specific...
But this requires to change the curriculums. There should be some coordination. Between the IIT and university, then and only then it's possible.
We are in touch with AICT for that matter. In fact, there is this review of curriculum happening, and in many of these committees, we have people who have offered courses through NPTEL or they're part of the IIT system itself, and they're trying to create some, you know, similarity between the curriculum being offered in the courses as well as what will be adopted by AICT as a model curriculum. Physics mein, for example, and I think Professor Manoj Harbola, he is the chairman of that particular committee.
Yeah. Right. He is taking the course of
electromagnetism. Right. So he is actually the chairman of that committee which is revising the curriculum. So in fact, I mean, if he has offered courses there, so I am sure he will try to bring in those components in the model curriculum also. But yes, there. See, right now, what is also happening is there are many new platforms which are coming up. And frankly, we are not very clear on, we are clear about one thing, that this is going to confuse the users quite a bit. So we had NPTEL, which was doing decent job. Then we have now SWAM platform, which is here. There is also SWAM Prabha, which is another initiative. Now I keep getting these questions, Sagar, in the sense that if we do a course on SWAM, can we appear for examination in NPTEL? Now, it's very silly problem. We are mirroring all the courses that we are actually offering on NPTEL in SWAM, but since these are two different entities, it becomes very difficult to engage. Then of course now you have these NRCs coming, National Resource Centers, which are going to offer courses to you. Just kar mein baat karunga abhi kuch mein. But so now NPTEL may be le sakte hain aap, NRC may be le sakte hain. SWAM, once the SWAM platform is ready and there is a serious effort going on in building up a platform for conducting examinations. Wo jab tak nahi hoga, we are dependent on some company or the other. But once that particular thing comes up, then perhaps it will be very useful. In fact, isi center mein there is wo jo building ban raha hai bahar, that is going to be the office of NTA, National Testing Agency. So, which is going to have all these 10 verticals, CBSE, ICSE, medical, JE, vagara, sab kuch. And it's their effort actually right now in building up a portal which could really conduct examinations properly. So, okay, sir, we'll look into this. Why? Ek saath hi karte na? Aap pehle khatam kar lijiye. Yes. Okay. There is one of the institutes in Pune that is actually working on this, and I think about 13 virtual labs are ready right now. So December mein, I think they are offering some of these training programs. Yeah, there are possibilities. It's just that the numbers, because when they, if they make it, you know, kind of mandatory for the students, I don't know whether we'll be able to accommodate all of them or not. That's why I was not saying. One needs to explore different possibilities. Hota kya hai na ki, if it is just about 30 students, 40 students, then things are possible. But, I mean, if you tell me there are about 2,000 students, and as soon as you tell me, I'm sure there are others also who would be interested in, then the numbers go up. There it becomes difficult for me to promise anything, you know, because we'll have to really build up the capacity first. I mean, uske baad hi kar sakte hain kuch. But I'm sure it's a good point. Just write a mail to me and do that before 3rd of next month. मोटिवेट नहीं होगा यार, मैं बता रहा हूँ आपको, वो नहीं करेगा कोर्स. सही बता रहा हूँ मैं आपको, वो अभी बता रहे थे ना कोई, वो कोर्स नहीं करेगा. आप लिख लो मुझसे, वो फ्री में मिलता है तो सोचेगा ऐसे ही चल रहा है. जिनको करना है करने दो. नहीं, मेंटर्स को हम दूसरी चीजें कर सकते हैं, बट एग्जामिनेशन फी वेवर मत कराओ. ये सेंटर की वजह से एग्जाम नहीं दे रहे हैं स्टूडेंट्स, या एक बार कर लोगे ठीक है. हाँ, absolutely. He doesn't have to appear for the exam. In fact, भाई दूसरे बार हम, I would say दूसरे बार आपके कॉलेज में that person should teach rather than you insist the students to take up the course here. Because the whole purpose was that once the mentor is now prepared, so it should be the mentor who's otherwise a faculty. He should be teaching the course. Why do you want the students to take up courses online then? What happens is, once students enroll for the exam, it is only at this, that stage we... Nahi, but how do we know that these students have actually... ठीक है, चलिए मैं एक्सप्लोर करता हूँ इसको भी. दीज आर गुड सजेशंस एक्चुअली. आप एक काम कीजिए, आई मीन आई थिंक यू हैव लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स दैट यू आर सेइंग, सो जस्ट ड्राफ्ट अ मेल टू मी एंड सेंड इट टू मी. ठीक है, आई विल पिक अप दीस पॉइंट्स.
कैन आई आस्क हिम वन क्वेश्चन?
या
सर, यू आर कंपनसेटिंग समर ट्रेनिंग विद द एनपीटीईएल सब्जेक्ट.
अभी नहीं है, अभी तो अप्रूवल नहीं चल रहा है.
बट एट दैट टाइम देयर इज नो एनपीटीईएल सब्जेक्ट ड्यूरिंग द समर ट्रेनिंग.
अभी इसलिए तो अप्रूवल में है ना, कि कैसे लेक्चर में सत्र सर कोर्स से चालू करेंगे बच्चे जाके डेडिकेटेड ट्रेनर, तो वो हमारे अप्रूवल में जाएंगे. पेंडिंग है एकेडमिक ऑफ द पास किया
Yeah, it depends on what. True, but then again, it depends on how you're looking at it. अब कोई physics का student है, you want the person to maybe register for some courses. That is their experience, in a way. I mean, not necessarily an internship means hands-on experience in the industry. Internships can happen in different ways. Yeah.
Sir, I'm from the school and from an academic college. I've been able to print out the university certificate. But the problem is that the session is starting from.
आपके वहाँ का राजमा चावल बड़ा अच्छा था यार. I went to their college actually. Yeah.
Sir, वो मैडम ने वो पूरा अंदर साफ फेमस कर दिया आपने राजमा चावल फेमस कर दिया.
बताइए.
Thank you sir. Thank you very much. तो sir वो problem ये आ रही है कि पंजाब यूनिवर्सिटी में session जो start हो रहा है वो 24
conducting awareness
of the same thing is happening on the near Batala mein bhi iske baad ek center bula raha hai media local chapter bula raha hai. Mumbai student CS right abhi maine sir se baat ki in Gurdaspur, unke sath ye they are affiliated to Gurnanak Dev University Amritsar, unke sath ye problem aa rahi hai ki classes abhi tak chhod nahi hui hai, students se enroll nahi hua hai. To kya kiya jaye? उसके लिए जो मैंने अपने यहाँ पे एक वे आउट निकाला कि जितने भी टीचर्स हैं और जो प्रोफेसर के मेंटर्स हैं, रिक्वेस्टेड दैट कि हम इंस्टेड ऑफ अ 12 वीक कोर्सेस वी ट्राई कि बच्चे जो है वो 4 वीक कोर्सेस तो एटलीस्ट पिकअप कर लें. देयर वी टू स्टार्ट आउट सम कोई 13 को स्टार्ट कर रहे हैं, 27 और तो
8 वीक्स
कोई लेकिन जो लेकिन 8 वीक में वो कोर्सेस नहीं है जो जो हमारे फॉर एग्जांपल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स या फिजिक्स के जो मेन कोर्सेस हैं.
अच्छा, ये एनरोलमेंट कोर्स एनरोलमेंट कितने दिन एक्सटेंड करने से कर सकते हैं स्टूडेंट्स? I'll tell you what the practical problem that we are facing right now, and I understand what you're saying. And we have to find a solution. If you really look at it as compared to what we were doing 2 years back, we have been pushing these dates. Abhi, 2019 May, January 26th now, is what we are going to start the course. Across the country, if you really look at it, wo der se do mahine tak ka difference hai. Now, if we delay it so much, the colleges in the south will suffer. If we prepone it, colleges in the north will suffer. So in that case, we really, the only solution that I can see is ki bhai, we offer different courses, start them differently so that everyone gets benefited to an extent. Aisa hi kuch kar sakte hai. But let me still explore the possibility. Abhi ke liye itna ho sakta hai ki thoda sa dates jo ye 12 weeks courses ka hai, अगर वो क्या अभी नहीं हुआ है क्या? सो विल मेक इट 10 डेज और सो 10-15 डेज. वन थिंग दैट यू कुड डू इज टेल योर मेंटर्स, दोज हु आर असाइंड टू दीज कोर्सेज, अदरवाइज दोज हु आर असाइंड टू दीज कोर्सेज टू रजिस्टर फॉर द कोर्सेज, राइट? सो दैट एटलीस्ट व्हेन द स्टूडेंट्स कम इन, इवन इफ दे एनरोल लिटिल लेटर, they can at least, if the mentors can do the course, they can always kind of tell the students or explain the concepts to the students. That way it can really help. वो खड़े हो गए पहले ही वो सॉरी ओके नहीं मेरे एक चीज समझ नहीं आ रहा है कि एनपीटेल ने एनसीआर के लिए कोई एग्जाम नहीं लिया था हाँ एग्जाम सिर्फ यूनिवर्सिटी ने ही लिया था हमने सिर्फ असाइनमेंट्स के स्कोर्स दिए थे अब वो हो गया ना दैट इज व्हाट आई वाज सेइंग वो अभी एक सेकंड लेट मी फिनिश दिस नाउ आई थिंक इन वन ऑफ द सर आपको तो पता होगा ना कुछ बता दीजिए आप ही मैं एकेडमिक काउंसिल की मीटिंग में था नहीं वो आप इस पॉइंट को जरा क्लियर कर ही दीजिए क्या एग्जैक्टली पॉलिसी हुआ है चलिए वो डर था कि मुझे बताया गया था एनसीआर का कोर्स इसलिए सिलेक्ट कर रहे हैं कि उसमें नंबर ज़्यादा आते हैं बच्चों के तो आई वाज एक्चुअली वरीड कि कम ना हो जाए फिर यूपीटी वाले आएंगे नहीं चलिए ठीक नहीं तो बट दैट डज नॉट आंसर सर दैट डज नॉट आंसर हिज क्वेश्चन आपके लिए इतना मैं बता रहा हूँ कि अब से इस सेमिस्टर से जो भी स्टूडेंट्स एनपीटेल के कोर्सेज में रजिस्टर करेंगे उनका क्रेडिट ट्रांसफर होगा अबाउट 20% ऑफ द कोर्स दैट दे ऐसा ही कुछ है ना 20% ऑफ द कोर्स एवरी सेमेस्टर I think it's for all the batches, right? सिर्फ फर्स्ट ईयर के लिए हुआ है अभी नहीं हुआ है उनका अच्छा चलिए मैं इसको अभी मीटिंग के बाद आई विल जस्ट टॉक टू देम एंड क्लैरिफाई दिस Yes, बताइए आज कौन सा दिन है सैटरडे आज अच्छा इंटरेक्शन अच्छा वो दैट ओके ओके दैट यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ऑलराइट हां ठीक है
ड्यूरिंग द क्लासेस टाइम
नहीं आई एग्री विद यू ऑन दैट ठीक है
सो दैट वी कैन प्लान एनी टाइम हो गया सेकंड थिंग इज सर लॉन्चिंग ऑफ ऑल द कोर्सेज एट द सेम टाइम व्हाट इज हैपनिंग राइट नाउ सेट 1 देन सेट 2 देन आफ्टर 15 मिनट्स सो ड्यूरिंग एकेडमिक सेशन दिस इज वेरी टफ टू अनाउंस अगेन दिस इज लास्ट डेट इज कमिंग प्लीज एनरोल लास्ट डेट इज कमिंग प्लीज एनरोल So if we can make it at one time event, then we will be very, you know, successfully promoting at the campus.
अभी देखिए मेरी समस्या कैसी हो जाती है अभी हम बता रहे थे वही कि अगस्त में जो ऑफर करेंगे कोर्स उसमें कुछ लोग कम से कम रजिस्टर कर सकते हैं उन्होंने तो कह भी दिया है कि अपने बच्चों को ये करने के लिए
But, sir,
The problem is, madam, that if I announce one date, this could be either beneficial for you or beneficial for colleges in the south.
Sir, then we can segment it that 12-week courses will be launched at one time and 8-week and 4-week will be launched at the second time. Otherwise, this is a mess.
No, the problem is that there are colleges which also want to take the 8-week courses now.
Yes.
Jinke colleges shuru ho gaye hain. So, ye bada mushkil hai.
Our classes are already starting. We have started.
वही हो रहा है ना कि आई मीन सी इफ आई हैव टू डू इट फॉर वन कॉलेज इट्स अ डिफरेंट थिंग. जैसे एकेटीयू के लिए जो किया था हम लोगों ने, दैट वाज अ सिंपल थिंग, वो हम लोगों ने बाहर किसी के लिए ओपन ही नहीं किया. नो द ओके द वे आउट इज बेसिकली मेक वन अनाउंसमेंट राइट नाउ सेइंग दैट दीज आर द कोर्सेज गोइंग टू ओपन अप फ्रॉम दीज डेट्स. Okay.
But, you know, at the last day, suppose the last day is tomorrow, then we really, put up a lot of effort before 2 days, that kindly those who haven't registered yet, please register. We go department to department for them.
Nee, I understand it is difficult, but again, you have to see that this is convenient for the students. So, that is something we have to cope up with. Yes. जरा शांत हो जाइए, सुन लें उनको. या नहीं नहीं आप वैसे तो पहले कर ही नहीं सकते हैं कि सबको फॉरवर्ड कर देंगे. यू हैव टू फर्स्ट लुक इनटू द जेन्युइन नीड्स ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स. नहीं वो तो बिकॉज दैट वाज अ व्हाइट लिस्टेड कोर्स, सो इस वजह से So the point, the problem is not in the scholarship, problem is in the level of seriousness. Those who are completing the course, enrolling for the exams, they are also applying for the scholarship, right? And those who are registering into a course but coming and bothering you and not appearing for the exam are not serious. So the problem is not with the scholarship, the problem is somewhere where they lack this seriousness. नहीं देखिए, आई मीन दैट इज समथिंग अ चॉइस. यू आर इन अ मच बेटर पोजिशन टू डिसाइड हु शुड अप्लाई फॉर स्कॉलरशिप एंड हु शुड नॉट अप्लाई फॉर स्कॉलरशिप. फॉर अस टू जज अदरवाइज बिकम्स अ वेरी डिफिकल्ट थिंग. I think it goes to the college account, right?
Yes, it goes to the SPOC.
SPOC account. वो चेंज हो गया है, राइट नाउ इट इज चेंज. अभी कॉलेज में ही जाता है वो. ओके सो लेट्स, हाँ चलिए आपको भी.
Run in parallel with the video, sir. Because this is a mirror problem, sir. it's become then very easy, sir. I have done one course from edX, sir, and the transcript is running parallel to the video. And they are highlighting it also, sir. So can it be there, sir?
I'll have to talk to Ashwini. Well, I'm sure it is possible. It's just that a small change means almost a huge effort. I know there was an effort being put in doing this. Why? I mean, this is something I'm saying because we discussed this about 2.5 years ago. I don't know why it has not been implemented. I didn't follow it up. Let me check. Kya hai? Uske baad dekh sakte hain. We can do that. We can do that. I mean, that is something which I have been telling the faculty colleagues. There is basically this four quadrant approach which has been taken now. People keep insisting that, we keep insisting our colleagues who offer courses to have more animations, more demonstrations and other things in the class. I'll get back to my colleagues and tell them to add more things. No. I completely agree with you and I personally feel that that's very important. You need to enrich your courses more. One of the things, of course, that we are trying is some of these courses which are now becoming more popular, those courses we are kind of taking it up and we are trying to enrich them with more interesting data. I agree with you. That makes it more interesting and exciting to watch.
More courses from a simulation point of view also, sir. Earlier, only a MATLAB course was there and that was in numerical analysis technique.
Right.
Since then, we do not have any MATLAB course for either electrical engineering or from any other background, sir. Only one course was there, sir.
Let me check. I'm sure there can be. Keep a note of this also. Some specific courses. I'll have to just go back and check out who can offer the courses.
Uske baad dekhte hain fir.
Okay, so right, this particular slide talks about the number of local chapters. So I'm very happy that Uttar Pradesh is on the top, but unfortunately it becomes very sad when we come here. If you look at the last point here, Maharashtra has the highest number of LCs after Uttar Pradesh. But registration is low. Why is it that the 30% students from Tamil Nadu, 18% from Andhra Pradesh and just 4% from UP? That is something which we need to figure out ways. Again, I mean, the problems that you are expressing are genuine, all genuine, but then everybody has the same problem, right? In spite of that, if there are some institutions which are trying to do good, एक बार काफी डिबेट हो गई थी वो कुछ लोग कहने लग गए कि पीपल इन साउथ आर मोर सीरियस एज कंपेयर टू नॉर्थ अबाउट एजुकेशन नाउ यू का यू नो दोज थिंग्स आर एम्बैरेसिंग व्हेन यू आर यू नो व्हेन यू आर इन अ सिचुएशन वेर यू आर एक्चुअली रिप्रेजेंटिंग द होल ऑफ नॉर्थ एंड देन यू आर टोल्ड कि मैं क्या करूँ मेरे डेटा नहीं है मेरे पास दिखाने के लिए April 2018, there were about 114 centers on each state across India. And I'm sorry that Udaipur did not have a center. Isko do 115 kar denge hum. Yeah. So just let me know and we'll do some study in that particular region and we'll figure out. And perhaps this semester, slightly early, let's plan a workshop at Udaipur and get all the colleges from the vicinity there. वहाँ एक बार जा चुका हूँ मैं सर अब वो जयपुर में है ना हाँ फाइन विल एक राउंड में कर लेंगे उसको ये राइट सो देवर ऑफलाइन एग्जामिनेशंस वेर कंडक्टेड इन सम प्लेसेस नाउ दैट इज ऑल्सो समथिंग वी कैन एक्सप्लोर विच वे नॉन टी सी एस विच वी कंडक्टेड ऑफकोर्स देवर रीजन्स पर हैप्स वाई दिस हैड टू बी डन दिस वे either TCS did not have a center or it was difficult for them to organize a center at a very short notice kuch issues hui thi us tarah ki
for us to find the TCS center
yeah
I am center department
theek hai aur ek problem ye bhi hota hai hum logo ko that we have to send these institute representatives to every center so I mean practically all my staff members even other IITs also those who are offering courses from at every TCS center every examination center we have to send two or three people so that also becomes slightly difficult to manage but I am sure things can be sorted out Yes. We may think of increasing the cutoff for passing from January 2019. Yes, I want a feedback. ये ऐसा कुछ नहीं सोच रहे हम लोग 50 करने की सोच रहे थे 40 से फोर्टीज ओके ठीक है सॉरी
इफ वी टॉक अबाउट क्वालिटी एंड रियल लर्निंग देन इट मस्ट बी
50% नहीं वो देखिए रियल लर्निंग वाला तो दोज हु आर ऑन द टॉप उनको रियल लर्निंग ही होता है ये पास वाला हो रहा है थोड़ा सा ठीक है चलिए नो आई एग्री विद यू ये मैंने नहीं कहा है ये किसी ने डिसाइड किया था उन्होंने भेजा है तो ये हम हटा देंगे डोंट वरी हाँ दिस इज समथिंग अंगन आई सपोज टू प्रेजेंट आई हैवंट सीन दीज स्लाइड्स व्हाट इज दिस अबाउट प्लीज एक्सप्लेन
How we have rated the local chapters, that is for every 10 students that were present for the exam, okay, that multiplied by 0.1 plus number of students who have got successfully completed certificates, that is 40% to 59% ke beech mein jo hai, plus 2 into number of the elite certificates. जो कि 60% से 89% है 10 इंटू नंबर ऑफ गोल्ड सर्टिफिकेट्स 90% टू 100% एंड प्लस 20 इंटू नंबर ऑफ नेशनल टॉपर्स ऑल दीज पुट टूगेदर वी फॉर ईच लोकल चैप्टर वी डू दिस कैलकुलेशन एंड देन वी पब्लिश द लिस्ट फर्स्ट ऑफ द रेटेड चैप्टर्स दैट इज ए डबल ए ट्रिपल ए And then the top 100 local chapters, and then the active local chapters. Okay, that is how it is done. And I tell this to all my spokes in all the workshops, but I still get mails. Madam, मेरा gold medal नहीं आया. So please, this is a virtual examination on a virtual. The examination is real. The teaching is virtual, and the platform is virtual. So gold medal is also virtual. It is printed on the top or right corner of the certificate. Okay, very nicely with a nice little ribbon tied like this. And beta, please, वही आपका gold medal है. Okay. Sir would not believe it, you know. So one day I opened my mailbox and I showed it to him. He said, "तुम हर वर्कशॉप में जाके ये बोलते हो, थोड़ी ना कोई ऐसा पूछता है। I said, okay, you see. So I opened my mailbox and I showed it to him. That's so many queries I get.
From next time you can start providing gold medals. Day by day going
there
popular. Is sir. Program is day by day going popular and most of the people
that's
are already.
That's your hard work, not completely our hard work. Yeah.
So next time we can plan that.
Okay, we will. Let's see.
Even for coated gold medal, need not to be
coated
a
gold
medal.
Yes,
yeah.
Sir, but program, you know sometimes coated gold medals are also very rare to get, you know. My son went for this district taekwondo championship.
Yeah.
Very happily he went, he came back. I said, because he had a big smile on his face, I said, kuch mila mila kya? So he said, yes, I've got a gold and two silvers. So I saw two silver medals hanging, but there was no gold medal. I said, rubbish, where's your gold medal? He said, kam padhiya tha. And I'm not joking. This was Uttar Pradesh district. I said, anything can happen here. Yeah, definitely padhiya hoga. Uttar Pradesh nahi ho sakta hai. कब मिलेगा पता नहीं जब बन के आएगा वो ऑटोमेटिक सर के पास आ जाएगा ऐसे ओके वेरी गुड एनीवे सो द टॉप 10 लोकल चैप्टर्स ऑफ द 100 ओके द टॉप 10 गेट ट्रिपल ए रेटिंग देन डबल ए एंड 51 टू 100 गेट द सिंगल ए रेटिंग सो यू विल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू नो दैट फ्रॉम आवर रीजन देर आर टू ट्रिपल एज दिस टाइम One double A, and I was very happy to see very hardworking spokes with a lot of single A rating. All the spokes whom I wanted to be in single A are there except two. No, three actually. I'll name them. One is Praveen Bhanodia from Acropolis Institute in Indore. He is one of my most hardworking spokes. Then Jyotirmay sir, he's been with us since day one. And Ashok ji from Jammu. I mean, please, Ashok ji, please stand up. And everyone, please clap for him. This man is a bundle of energy. I can assure you, Jammu se jitne registrations hue hai, it's not our effort. It's totally his. And you will not believe where his college is. It's in Samba where every day shelling takes place. Every day, jab hum gaye the wahan pe, you know, we were not allowed to go out after 6 o'clock in the evening because shelling was taking place. Aur raat ko jab soye the, to first time in my entire life, I thought, barish to nahi ho rahi hai, itna thunder kahan se aa raha hai. It was not thunder. From there, students have sat for the examinations. It's this man's single-handed effort. So I just say, you know, if he can do it, if he can do it, then any of us can do it. Any of us can do it. So thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay. So rating changes every semester. This is not the end of the road. I want that pile to go up. And so this is how you can be at least an active local chapter. 25 candidates need to be present for the April 2018 exam. Or, first it was an and, now we have put an or. That local chapters have either one gold medalist or one topper in any of the course. So even if you do not have 25 candidates sitting for the exam, if you have one gold medalist or one national topper, even then you are an active local chapter. So 452 plus 101 local chapters are tagged as active based on this run. Of course, we have certificates for spokes of the top 100 local chapters, and the active local chapters are acknowledged. Well, we are thinking of changing our LC ratings now that we are thinking of either removing the capping on the successfully completed or taking into account only the elite and the gold. And what is important is the next point, that spokes should do some minimum activity of logging in into the portal. and answering the survey. You have all received a feedback form.
Enrolled with mentees list attached,
mentor certificate.
We had this discussion of whether if the mentor has to
register
again for a course next semester, this will not be applicable.
Mentor certificates will not be given. Okay, so if somebody, as sir said, if somebody has already done a mentoring this time, we can get a fresh person to mentor that course this time if you want him or her to get a certificate.
Ma'am, can we get those slides?
Which slides?
This PPT.
I'll share with you.
No problem. Okay, thank you.
Anyway, if you open the npdl.ac.in site, there is a column called presentations. If you click on the presentations, a number of presentations will drop. You just look for the July to November, this session presentation, and the entire presentation will open.
Next. Some of the information are not there.
All are not there, then I'll share. I will share, no problem. I have the registration list with me, I will share with all of you. So, a feedback form for mentors has to be filled once a month. The mentor himself or herself will get a feedback form. He has to or she has to fill it and send it back to us. It will involve details about the course and how they handle. So if they have any issues with the course, they find the course tough, they find the course out of context, they find something else to be included, then the mentor should put that in the feedback form to help us develop the course better. Additional mentors for every 50 students enrolled. If it is less than 50 number of students, then we recommend one mentor. Alright, the last point is that we may think of whether 10 mentees and they do not pass, whether we can give the mentor a certificate or not, that we are thinking of changing this time, but we might not change. There's nothing to worry right now. Alright, that's from my end. After I distribute the certificates, I would like some of the spokes to share their experiences with NPTEL and how they have handled it. And you know, then you have so many queries, certain queries will get answered, you know, by default. That's, you know, how people have handled it. Okay, so I'll continue with it. IIT Madras, Roorkee, Palakkad and Tirupati have approved credit transfer students taking NPTEL online courses, and 300 students from various IITs have taken exams in January to April run. I also have a list of universities who have already implemented this credit transfer. So one is, of course, AKTU for the NCR course, the credit transfer was implemented. Gujarat Technical University, they do it for their research skill project. Okay, that they have an activity of 50 points, which the students generally had to go outside, like, you know, like taking an internship or something. That has been covered up by NPTEL. University of Madras, of course, they included the UGC regulation for including MOOCs. And in the UGPG program, so they have the BTEC 8th semester students opting completely for MOOCs courses. Then they will also have to appear for the NSEM exams. Students have to submit their respective colleges and certificates obtained. So that is for University of Madras, who have completely taken up the UGC regulation for their final year students. Alright? So one course completely is done by through NPTEL. Generally, the 30 hours course is done by these students. The 30 hours course completes around 4 to 5 credits for them. That is how it is applicable. Of course, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad University of Technology in West Bengal, Kolkata, for them also, they have also included this in their course curriculum. And students who complete 20 credits from MOOCs courses get a BTEC degree with honors. okay, something in line that even Abdul Kalam Technical University is thinking of doing, that if you complete 20 credits from MOOCs courses, then they will also get a B.Tech degree with honors. That depends on which course you are taking, 4 weeks, 8 weeks, 12 weeks. So depending on that, you can transfer your credit.
So how many?
That generally the college maps it within observing their own credit structure. So like 4 weeks course transfers to 1 credit, and 8 weeks course transfers to 2 credits, and 12 weeks transfers to 4 credits.
So like that.
4 credits. 12 weeks generally a 4-credit course. But it again, you can map it according to your requirements.
I am from University of Hotel
Management.
In our university, we are proposing that students should appear for 6 MPTL courses, starting from 2nd semester up to 7th semester. And we are mapping it according to our criteria.
Yes.
That means we are, if the courses, even by MPTL is 2 or 3 credit, we are taking it as 1 credit and we are adding it in our certificate. Is it perfect?
Actually depend on how you map it. It is up to you how you use it. I think you're from Jaipur.
This is basically just a slide which I think there are two slides where we just wanted to tell you how people are using the courses in different forms of credits. This is something we can share with you also, which you can take back and in case you need any help to follow some of these models. If you look at this, this particular institution in Gujarat, they say NPTEL certification of an 8-week course will be considered equivalent to 3 or 4 credit elective for awarding exemption. NPTEL certification of a 12-week course will be considered equivalent to 5 or 6 credit elective. So, it largely depends on, varies from university to university, colleges to college. So as per your requirements are concerned, you can map it for your own requirement, I mean, system that you follow.
So, this time AKTU has given this MCA course also in the NPTEL, the elective subject of one of the MCA courses, which is there in the fifth semester. Do students have to give the online exam or they have to give the AKTU exam for that particular course?
No. Henceforth, all the courses that are listed in NPTEL, in AKTU side, NPTEL will be doing it. NPTEL will be doing it, and there will be students other than AKTU also who would be registering for it. That will be like a regular NPTEL course. Up say, exam, first time we were experimenting, we were not very clear, kaise kya karna nahi karna, university conducted the examination. And it was specifically offered for students of AKTU as a whitelisted course. But now it is an open NPTEL course, so students will get the NPTEL certificate also as any other student.
Okay.
For this particular course, there will be a certificate which will be issued. But that will be not like a regular NPTEL certificate, it will be a certificate offered by IIT Kanpur in collaboration with AKTU, offered this course under the umbrella of NPTEL. That is what.
But it will be an online exam. It will be like normal NPTEL exam.
No,
it will not be done in offline
mode.
No. So,
but
there will not be credit transfer. There will not be any credit transfer
for this thing? Yeah, so there is a mechanism for it. So, students have to, or colleges have to inform the university, these are the students and these are the courses that they have cleared. Based on that, the credits will be transferred.
Again,
sir,
Ghaziabad is having many colleges from MCA, and we are not having centers in the Ghaziabad. We are having centers in the Delhi.
Just note this
yes, sir.
For the third meeting. Ghaziabad and
Udaipur.
Sorry? These three we can do it. Right, so let's look at some of these future plans and new initiatives.
Obviously, a desirable state would be to repeat core courses in all major disciplines in July and January semesters, offer interesting and new electives regularly. To an extent, we are doing it, but of course, we don't have core courses in all major disciplines. In one of the workshops, or actually a couple of workshops, we were told that textile and mining, these are two areas where we need more courses. That now has been taken care of. So hopefully by July 2019, earlier we had thought it will be July 2020, but hopefully by July 2019, our schedule of courses should be available ahead of time. There could be some problems here and there in one or two courses, but like it happened in the current semester itself. We were offering a course in which about 1,500 students already registered, and then two faculty members were jointly offering that course. One faculty member had to, he left for US for a semester or so, and that we were not informed, and suddenly we came to know about this. By the time it was too late, so I had to really identify another faculty member from IIT Delhi now, of course. So both of them together are going to offer the course, but agar registration matlab schedule hum de bhi dete hain to bhi there could be a possibility that some courses are dropped and replaced. We will try as far as possible not to avoid such situations. And of course, once we have another reason why we wanted to talk about this is also because it's very important for us to, like, from our side we can give you the schedule of courses, but if you can give us the schedule of examinations and schedule of admissions and new semester starting and all that, that will be very useful for us. In fact, we are going to take a feedback on that account, and this is something I want to understand, so that at least this whole problem of students not there when the course starts, I don't know what the solution could be, but we can still at least deliver it on this. A sheet with a tentative list of courses which are going to be offered from January 2019 will be shared with you very soon. If you have any specific requirement of courses, you can let Angana inform her about that. Yes, as I said, last 2 years in various places that we went, there was this demand of courses in textile engineering and mining. Unfortunately, textile engineering is only taught at IIT Delhi right now. There are some courses at IIT Kanpur also, but so now they have agreed to offer some courses. Mining, IISc Dhanbad has agreed to offer some courses from there. So therefore, these two set of courses are going to be offered. Yes, this is an important thing. Advanced courses will be approved as FDP courses. The list of courses which will be available for you will be uploaded on the website. There will be a notification from AICT very soon. In fact, day before yesterday, there was a meeting at MHRD. We are also going to offer these courses as part of the National Resource Centers. There are about some 72 National Resource Centers which have opened up. But I am the coordinator for Aerospace Engineering IIT Kanpur. IIT Kanpur is the National Resource Center for Aerospace Engineering courses. So these will start from October 2018. That's the plan which we have. I don't know if all the National Resource Centers will be able to offer the courses right away, but at least this initiative has started, which I believe is a good initiative. You don't really have to travel and make your plans advance. This will be online. Purely online courses, just like NPTEL courses, you'll have, duration could be smaller. It could be a 4 weeks course or 2 weeks course, these kind of durations. But you will get credits for FTP otherwise. This we have been actually, based on the feedback that we received from many of you, we have been following it up with AICT and they have approved it. So If you are interested, apply for IIT NPTEL FTP certificate through a separate link that will be uploaded. Fee of rupees 200 if hard copy is desired, is 100 rupees is the fee. अब यार अब टीचर्स को बोल
मतलब आधा
से सौ कर दिया यार अब
अब प्रॉमिस कर रहा है सनी करेगा 100%
गुड यार दिस इज बेसिकली द डिफरेंस इफ यू रियली लुक एट इट
सर ये स्लाइड
हम लोग को शेयर
करो बिल्कुल सर
ये हम प्लीज पूरा पीपीटी दे दीजिए
पूरा
पीपीटी
बिल्कुल
पीपीटी हो जाएगा श्योर
ये एक्चुअली ये मेरे ख्याल से एपिटल वेबसाइट पे है भी बट आई एम
हम लोग शेयर करते हैं
So if you really look at this, it's just kind of a difference between the two modes. When you think of a short-term course, when you go to another institution, typically it ranges between 10,000 to 20,000 rupees. While here, registration fee is not important. I think examination wala kuch to hai. So that is precisely what we are trying to take. Travel typically involves, you know, booking the tickets well in advance, accommodation, all of that. No travel accommodation required in this case. Leave of absence, 8 to 12 days of academic leave. Wo aapka bach gaya. And all participants are exposed to lectures only once. Here, whatever is being recorded, it's there for you for reference. Later on, you can use them. We would like to take an examination also in this. I'm sorry, ma'am is looking at me. Phir exam karwa rahi hai, assignment bhi karwayenge. But the fact is, you think of it, those who come for these FDPs, I have conducted several of these courses. Generally, my observation is people would come, they would attend the lectures, and they would also like to look at, you know, search for the malls in the city and all of that, which you are always free. In this case, kabhi bhi mall pe jaake bhi baith ke in Starbucks you can listen to the lectures now. So that is taken care of.
Sir, college will consider this as a
Yes, it has to. It is basically a circular. A letter would come very soon. Mere khayal se wo issue ho bhi gaya hai wo. I think within 2 or 3 weeks, your college would get the letter from ASA. So this is something I had promised about 3 years ago, I remember. So, 3 years lag hai, ye karne mein, but it is now there in place. In fact, the discussion on this happened in AKTU, in Vice Chancellor's office itself, when AICT chairman was there and your Vice Chancellor had taken charge on that very week. So, we had this discussion. So now, finally, it is seeing the light. Yeah, so in case you miss out these courses, there will of course be several reruns also, so there is no worry about that. Yes, this is again important, but I am not very clear about this because hamare yahan par hota nahi hai. Aap log samjha sakte hain mujhe kya hai? I was actually sent this slide by AICT. So it says half FDP credit for a 4 weeks course. One FDP of 1 week for 8 weeks, which essentially means 8 FDP credits, and then 18 for 12 weeks. That is the kind of calculation. I don't know. If you can explain this to me, that will be very nice.
NAC wants 15 days FDP also, sir.
Sorry?
NAC wants 15 days FDP also to be participated by the faculty members.
So, uske liye there is NRC also. That's what I'm saying. This is, I'm talking about NPTEL courses as FDP, the National Resource Center that we are setting up, that will not be under NPTEL umbrella, it is under NMEICT, another initiative, but that I think there is already a circular which has been sent to the universities, so that these courses will start from October. So, usme there are these 10 hours courses, 15 hours courses and all that.
Which courses are
NRC, National Resource Center. These courses will be offered through the SWAM platform. That is right.
Yes.
And October is the time which
one has. Not sure about that.
In October, NRC, the courses will be
closed. NRC is another platform, like you have NPTEL.
Yes, yes.
Okay, let me explain
this.
स्वयं के बारे में आप लोगों ने सुना हो स्वयं क्या है व्हाट इज स्वयं There's a huge confusion about this.
Right.
So, Swayam means two things. One is there is the Swayam platform, like we use Course Builder, and then Swayam also means a gateway, a single gateway for all e-learning initiatives in the country. Abhi tak kya hota tha that different groups, different institutions, different bodies were actually offering courses. Not all these certificates were approved by ICT or colleges. They were not given real credits. Now in this case, once you are moving through Swayam as a platform, then all these courses will have acceptability. That's the whole point. Okay. Now there are different projects under NMEICT, now of course under the Swayam gateway. NPTEL is also one. Similarly, UGC is offering one. There could be, you know, IIIT Hyderabad, they are thinking of something, they can put their you know, platform also in it. So NPTEL remains as one platform in Swayam itself. You can do courses on NPTEL. Similarly, for NRC, National Resource Center, there are about 72 of them. I may be wrong, So different institutions in the country have been assigned responsibility for creating contents in different disciplines. Okay. For example, IIT Kanpur is taking care of computer science. IIT Kanpur is taking care of aerospace engineering. So in this case, the advantage that you have is that these are almost like refresher courses, degrees, where courses will be offered online on the Swayam platform. I am not very sure about the examination component in Swayam as of now. Will there be an examination? What did Manaj say?
Sir, you talk about it.
So, most likely there will not be an exam as far as National Resource Centers are concerned. NPTEL, there is an examination component. And also, along with the courses, there is always a possibility that we would have on-site visits also, which is not purely online. Most of the courses will be online, but if there are, for example, I was talking to the aerospace guy the other day, a course like Introduction to Airplane Performance, for example, it requires people coming to the site. I think it has its own airstrip when there are aircrafts, so practical training there itself. So, that is one experiment that we are starting with, where some of these courses could be a combination of online and offline. Okay.
Sir, this slide needs clarification.
Sorry?
This slide needs clarification.
Yeah.
How the certificate will be given to the faculty? For example, 1/2 FD of 1 week. For example, a faculty take the course for 4 weeks.
Right.
So how the certificate will be given to them?
So those who actually register to the course, those who complete the course, the organization offering the course, and in this case it is NPTEL.
Half FDP.
Hmm.
What does it mean, sir?
Which essentially means it is 2 FDP for a 4 week course.
And one complete FDP would consider.
Yeah.
One complete FDP.
So, I mean, that is precisely what I was asking. I mean, how many FDPs do you need in a year? Kuch aisa kuch hai kya aap logon ka?
That is not there. That is not there.
Huh? 3 MPP per year,
yeah.
You need to have.
Yeah.
That's mandatory. So in this case, perhaps.
He has one suggestion that why only AICT/UGC should also.
No, I think the letter will be issued. I mean, both of them know about this. So go implement it. It's not just AICT. UGC is well informed about it, and they would also. I mean, they have been told.
Clarification
in the sense, as far as certificates are concerned, when you do a refresher, when you go to a particular institution to do a course, how does that work? You come back and you submit some documents, right?
Yes.
That you have completed a course. Similarly, the certificate that you get after completing it would be considered equivalent to submitting a document otherwise as a practice which is being followed, right? Yeah.
Sir, actually, sir, API is
एट दैट टाइम दे से कि 15 दिन की आपने करी है एक हफ्ते की करी है तो इतने पॉइंट्स मिलेंगे वो चीज इस पर ही इंडिकेटेड है सर एक्चुअली दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम सर
ठीक है I'll clarify this जहाँ तक मुझे समझ में आ रहा है जहाँ तक मुझे समझ में आ रहा है इसको देखकर that every week there will be three lectures for every week of course that you do you'll get half FDP. Yes. So which essentially means for a 4-week course, it becomes 2 FDP.
2 FDP over how many days? That is important, sir.
4 weeks.
Please, sir.
Okay.
Price is for expressing
it.
Okay.
ठीक है नहीं ठीक है कैन यू जस्ट ड्रॉप मी अ मेल एक मेल कर दीजिए प्लीज एंड इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट प्लीज डू दैट वो आप कर दीजिए मुझे आई विल टेक इट अप इट्स पॉस बिकॉज दिस इज समथिंग विच आई एम नॉट वेरी क्लियर अबाउट ठीक है डन ये आई विल क्लैरिफाई बाय आफ्टर बाय थर्ड बिल्कुल बिल्कुल सो Yeah, these are some of the courses I was talking about. There are courses which we are doing in collaboration with the industry. So for people who are doing multiple courses, there is also this whole initiative of giving a consolidated transcript that may have some value. We don't know. We just got this feedback ki ek saath ek wo hona chahiye. So that would look somewhat like this, where you have for multiple courses, you have this particular set. And these are all going to be online. So we are not. अरे सर माफ कर दो यार. फिर पैसे मांगने शुरू कर जाएंगे ना हम लोग. वो see once we it's a simple thing. As soon as we say we give you hard copy. नहीं वो है ना उसके लिए पैसे हैं
नहीं सर मैंने मेंशन सब का सी सेट किया ऐसा कोई ऑप्शन नहीं है
क्या नहीं है
सर मैंने नो हार्ड कॉपी का भेज दिया है आईटी कानपुर से ये अवेलेबल नहीं है सर दे आर सेइंग ओनली द ऑप्शन इज देयर ऑफ प्रिंट आउट बाय ऑनलाइन दैट्स
इट सो यू वांट टू गो ग्रीन दैट्स व्हाई ये देखिए ना इफ हार्ड कॉपी ऑफ सर्टिफिकेट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड द कोर्स एग्जाम फी विल बी 1000 इंसटेड ऑफ ₹1100 But after filling the form, if the candidate wants the hard copy sent by us, he/she will have to fill another form and pay ₹200 for the same. I didn't formulate this rule. मुझे नहीं पता इसके बारे में. So this was basically, I'll tell you what. No, generally hard copies में क्या हो रहा है? There are 2-3 issues which we are facing. One is, of course, I'll show you a slide. You know, there is a boy who registered for the course. Registered for the exam, and instead of his passport size photograph, he pasted Sachin Tendulkar's photo. It went unnoticed. Certificate was printed. Someone actually pointed it out. He can. Then we realized it is something as stupid as this. But we don't understand that costs. Even if I say 25 paisa, it costs for printing that. But if you really look at it, that for many certificates get wasted. Yeah, and some of these, I'll show you some images today of these passport size photographs of people. They're hilarious. This is actually, these are extremely boring things to read out, but generally what you see, I will share this presentation, please have a look at it. This is generally for the students with in reserve category as well as physically handicapped. So for them it is, there are several levels of exemptions which are there. So it's basically 50% if just reserve category plus physically handicapped, another 50% over that. So it's just ₹250 as compared to ₹1000. Wo kahan gaye wo? There was somebody who was asking about these. Virtual virtual labs. No, he has left. Anyway, so 12 experiments have been set up physically, simulation components available for practice. They can be remotely controlled, performed, and measurement can be taken by booking of slots, in-person workshop to introduce some faculty to the same. Now, this is something which the in-person workshop we are going to start from December. We are talking to this organization in Pune, and I'm sure things will be in order soon. ISA Pune will offer a pilot lab certification course in organic chemistry. This will start from December 2018. But it can handle only 50 participants at a time. So this is also something which you can take a note of. Inform your colleagues in chemistry, organic chemistry. If they are interested, they can do this. Summer internships have started. So May-June 2018, about 6 candidates who were toppers in NPTEL courses were selected at IIT Madras. One candidate went to IIT Bombay, one went to Triple IIT Bombay, and 4 candidates to IIT Kharagpur. So that is something we can, which could be another incentive perhaps for some students who are genuinely interested in pursuing their career in academics or otherwise. But this is only given to the toppers. No, one issue, I think what you're talking about is an informal arrangement what we had so far. Now it is basically a formal arrangement. There's a link provided there. Students who have actually kind of secured high marks in the courses, they can apply through that link. Okay. So that particular thing, I think it has an option where you want to apply, with whom you want to work and all those.
Internshala
is different. Internshala is different. What you do is send them a link of this page. Mail them a link of this page.
He is here,
the
person who was talking about virtual labs.
Yeah. So, this is something which could be of some use to you. About 12 experimental setups. And you have simulation and other things also. You can perhaps, I mean, we're going to start with this from December onwards. So perhaps next year you can explore this. There is this mobile version of online course portal. Right now we are still in a developmental stage. You cannot register into a course or enroll into a course or register for exams, but you can view the lectures. Yeah. But this will take another 6-7 months before we are ready. We can do away with some of these things. Yes, this is an important slide perhaps now. You already have this information. So, one of the questions which you were asking, see, many of these things also depends on our own preparedness. We like these differences, you know, 13th August and 6th August, a lot of it also depends on how many courses are we, our team ready with. And we are trying to impose on our faculty member colleagues that the course should be completely recorded and edited before we offer the course. To an extent that has happened, but still we are, you know, still lagging behind slightly. Some courses which are scheduled
students have started, you know, registering for the courses, enrolling for the courses. In them, we've hardly completed about 20 or 30% recordings. So, वो भी एक reason है थोड़ा बहुत इधर उधर हम लोगों को करना पड़ता है उसको.
So I believe those who are targeting August 20, I mean August for enrollment have about 43 courses. Plus, of course, 6th August, 71, and you know another 19 courses, 13th August. Perhaps that is something which you could target. Yeah, this is something which we have already, we are aware, and we discussed it also some time back. As far as the examination centers in Ghaziabad, Greater Noida, and Udaipur is concerned, I'm surprised that Greater Noida still does not have a center.
Greater Noida did have a center because it only gives us the numbers.
Sir, Gurgaon should also get
it. It's almost like a chicken and egg problem. So until and unless you have students, you won't give centers. But until and unless you have centers, you won't
get students. That's the problem in Gwalior and in Gorakhpur.
Okay, I mean, this is something we'll take it up this time. The delay in dispatch of hard copies of certificates, we fixed it and all results released on May 28, 2018, within a month, and certificates reached before third week of June. But still we have a huge number of certificates which are coming back to us because either addresses were wrong or there is some problem or the other. See that. I mean, I can clearly see, and that's also one reason apart from the Go Green concept that was talking about. Perhaps we are still not equipped to handle this at this stage right now. Because finally, our offices are also very small, and there are, you know, running 226 courses at a time itself is a humongous task. सर्टिफिकेट्स में एक तो वो नाम का प्रॉब्लम होता है, इमेजेस के प्रॉब्लम होते हैं. क्रिएटिंग ईच ऑफ दी सर्टिफिकेट्स, यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड देर आर 70,000 पीपल हु हैव टू बी गिवन सर्टिफिकेट्स एंड देर आर 5 पीपल इन माई ऑफिस हु आर मेकिंग सर्टिफिकेट्स फॉर देम. दैट रियली बिकम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट. इट्स आई थिंक वी विल हैव टू फिगर आउट सम वे. ई सर्टिफिकेट इज द वे आउट. अगर आपको स्पेशली चाहिए तो आपके लिए स्पेशली कुछ किया जाएगा. But we will have to do away with this. This of course will be changing because we have to again request them for an extension. We thought this time things are more or less stable, but I believe some problems are still there. Yeah, one thing that is important is to tell the students to check the email notifications. Whenever you address the students after the course registration starts, that's very important because what is happening right now, I'm seeing, in fact, with EKTU courses also this time, my office, I had given about 3 numbers for people to access. One of them was, of course, Ms. Nadi Dutta. She told me that she was getting phone calls at 12 o'clock in the night, 2 o'clock in the night. And on a special request, she had kept her phone on. But the queries were such that which have been posted on AKTU website, it has been posted on the course page, it has been mailed to students at least 3 or 4 times, and still they would prefer to call up. Oh, I was actually going through this joke. Somebody said, Hindustan mein mail karne se nahi, mail karke aapko phone karke batana padega ki mail kiya hai. So it's almost like that. But please tell the students to check emails. Yes, look at these wonderful images.
you know, Yuduk, they're still decent. Some of them were, we could clearly see somebody, a girl in a mall in front of Starbucks. You want this image to go in a certificate.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's also something I would request you to please tell them. On one occasion, get a serious academic looking passport size photograph, which you can use later for visa, but abhi ke liye ek kar lo, ek decent sa image. Otherwise, it looks very funny. The whole weight, the value of the certificate goes down. We generally tell the students, please place a photograph, but otherwise also it becomes very difficult. Also the signatures, I mean, these are all specimen. I am not joking. I mean, these are things that we get from students. So we, of course, don't entertain these things, but this needs to be avoided because it's very difficult during, you know, examination when we actually try to kind of check the identity of the students. That time, these things become very important. In case a student is absent or has not passed a course, NPTEL will be unable to facilitate supplementary exams. Assignments with solutions are open and available. Local faculty can set the question paper based on this conduct internally. NPTEL will not change scores on website or issue certificate. This is a problem that we are genuinely facing. Once a course is offered, and this is only for institutions where they are using it for credit transfer. Once an examination is conducted, for instructors and their team, PAs and all that, those who prepare the question papers with us, there is an amount that we have to pay for every course, recording lectures to giving us the question papers. There is a fee for that we pay. Now once the faculty colleague has given a question paper, asking the person to again set up a question paper becomes a difficult task for us. We have been informally entertaining this for some time, but now it looks, because the demands are also going up. This time at least I know there have been requests from 15 different institutions for, you know, giving us question papers, which essentially means that that costs close to about 7.5 lakhs. Now that becomes difficult for us. So ideal thing would be that if the course is being offered for credit transfer, assuming that there is a mentor who is also part of the course, he can actually set up the question paper and conduct the examination. कम से कम ये तो नहीं बोलेंगे कि भाई हमारे पास कोई काम नहीं है. Question paper तो बना सकते हैं ना. So that is something which you can again tell them. Oh God. No fee waiver for faculty members. For Tier 1 city candidates, Tier 2 candidates, SPOC has to mention the criteria used and if required should produce supporting documents such as income certificate or ration card. So again, you know, it's sad, but then what we observed is people are taking advantage. So we came across some cases where it happened in Maharashtra actually. So where the SPOC had given, you know, did not give us all these information, but based on their feedback, we offered scholarships to the students. And later on, someone reported us, and then we investigated the matter. We found that these were not genuine cases. The sad thing is that we know there are many other students who could have benefited otherwise, who genuinely needed it. So therefore, all these rules. Frankly, we don't feel good about it, but we don't have a choice that way. Yes. Now, I would sincerely request all of you, those who have talked about different things, to send me a mail as early as possible, because I am going on 3rd for this meeting. Before that, I would like to carry all these informations with me. And if you send me early, then I can kind of talk to some other members before the meeting starts, so that we can have a pre-meeting discussion also on these topics.
So there are
उनका दे दीजिए, हाँ उनका दे दीजिए, बिकॉज मेरा कुछ पता नहीं है क्या है. आई थिंक शी कैन कलेक्ट ऑल दीज इंफॉर्मेशन. राइट, सो नाउ द गुड पार्ट स्टार्ट्स. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन क्वेरीज दैट यू वुड लाइक टू हैव? ही इज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड, ही इज क्लैपिंग. Special cases are always considered.
So he's never to appear in the attachment for examination. At the same course, he will be in the next hospital semester.
Right.
Is it possible for the student to appear in the same course?
The SPOCs have to inform us immediately, and then we can follow it up. What happens is, agar hum logon ko pata nahi hai, there is a genuine reason, and after we have created the list based on which centers, seats, everything has been decided, 3 days before the exam, the student says, I want to appear for the exam, that is not possible. But if you inform us well in advance, then it is possible. So how do we go about it?
They haven't really got a certificate this time, but they have done so well in the capacity of spokes that their names are featured in the local dailies of Madhya Pradesh, and their students have done really very well this time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Shivani Gupta, ma'am from IIT Kanpur. Single A rated college. She had missed it last time by one. This time she got it. And again, two top performing.
This is good because the mentor certificate should be heavy like this.
Yes.
Quite a few of them.
With two top performing mentors.
Very good.
Dr. Abhish Gupta, single A, rated college. Sanjay Tiwari from BN College. Sandeep Das from Jaipur.
Now, would you like to share something here?
No, certificate.
Sorry?
For us, we are receiving a
e-certificate. I think it's a little bit. Just a little bit. आप जरा अपने वाला दे दीजिए वो फ्रेम तो कम से कम आ जाए उसमें
Thank you.
Your colleges to conduct workshops.